The Supreme Court en banc has dismissed the quo warranto petition versus ABS-CBN filed by Solicitor General Jose Calida due to mootness. Mike Navalio joins us for details. Mike, go ahead.
Hi, Randy. Supreme Court en banc just a few hours ago has junked the quo warranto petition filed by Solicitor General Jose Calida against ABS-CBN Corporation. Supreme Court sources told ABS-CBN News the petition seeking to nullify the franchise of ABS-CBN Corporation due to alleged violations was dismissed because it was already moot and academic, a legal concept which means that there is no longer a justiciable controversy to be decided on. ABS-CBN Corporation's franchise lapsed on May 4, which means that there no longer exists a franchise to invalidate. Efforts to renew ABS-CBN's franchise continue to languish in Congress. Sources, however, said that the quo warranto petition against ABS-CBN Convergence, Inc. remains pending since magistrates believe Convergence's franchise is still existing. ABS-CBN Convergence obtained its franchise through Republic Act 7908, granting Multimedia Telephony, Inc. a franchise on February 23, 1995. On June 30, 1997, however, RA 8332 amended RA 7908 to allow additional services such as mobile, cellular, wired or wireless telecommunication systems and value-added services. But in a disclosure to the Philippine Stock Exchange in March this year, ABS-CBN Convergence said its franchise expired on March 17, 2020 and has suspended operations which require a legislative franchise or provisional authority. The dismissal, however, does not affect the petition filed by ABS-CBN asking for a temporary restraining order against the cease and desist order issued by the National Telecommunications Commission, which led to the shutdown of the media giant on May 5th. That petition will still be discussed on July 13th. Rain?
What is the next step for this quo warranto case, Mike? Should there be a reply coming from Soljan Calida?
Well, as to the dismissal, Rain, the Office of the Solicitor General can ask for a reconsideration. They can file a motion for reconsideration with the Supreme Court and hope that the justices will change their minds. But we know that there's still a pending petition against ABS-CBN Convergence, and that will still be the subject of further deliberations. Now, the Supreme Court will have to determine when is the actual expiration date of the franchise of ABS-CBN Convergence, given the two laws that I mentioned. And in that particular case, there may still be some filings that may be made if the Supreme Court decides to ask for clarification from the parties. But as it is now, all the pleadings have been filed before the Supreme Court. We note that the quo warranto petition was filed in February this year, so they have had several months to go over it. And there are no longer any pleadings that need to be submitted as of this time. As for the other petition, for the temporary restraining order, we understand that the magistrates will deliberate on it on July 13th.
And we will continue to monitor developments from the Supreme Court. Thank you so much for that report, Mike Navalio.